Hey YouTube, this is Zach with Achilles Financial, and today I'm going to be talking about Lucid Group, an EV stock, and they had a quite eventful day. Some of this was following the broader market over the course of the past week, and some of this is based strictly on the news that Lucid Group did receive an SEC subpoena, where they are being asked to provide additional information associated with their SPAC merger. That SPAC merger created a total of $4.4 billion in liquidity associated with the group, and they took them public at a total volume or total worth of about $24 billion. As of today's closing price, the company is coming in right at about $74 billion in total market cap. And you can see some of that here, more than a 300% return off of the original price, which is absolutely insane. And a lot of this is going to be volatile going forward, because overall the valuations in EV stocks are not directly tied to their fundamentals, which causes the potential for some serious trading volume and gamma squeezes that can cause a stock to rocket highward or higher or skyward. I want to highlight that when I'm thinking about this, normally I can think of Tesla. But right now, what I want to focus on is not the EV industry in general, because again, a lot of that does trade based off of volume versus fundamentals. But there are a number of good things that are positive for Lucid going forward. Now, at this point in time, one of the things that's cool to look at is the chart here, where we see that volume coming in. Again, this was when the company was CSIV, or when they were in their pre-SPAC merger. They dropped dramatically from where they were, which was nearly $70 a share at one point, and they crashed back down. And as they approach the, or after hours, they're about $44.70. And so there's going to be continued volatility here, but we've got the question of what are we looking for going forward. They had a series of positive news that have come out over the course of the past 2 to 3 weeks. The first thing I would highlight is their reservations for their Lucid Air is currently sitting about 17,000, up from what they had previously said was 13,000. So that book alone represents about 1.3 billion in new orders, because that model or that vehicle starts at about $77,000. So there is sufficient sales order volume there. One of the things that I would highlight, though, is that we don't necessarily have the exact timeline on when they'll be able to deliver on all of that. And again, the overall market cap right now is about $74 billion. So the expectation is that that is going to continue to build in terms of the market capitalization, solely based off the fact that they're expecting some serious growth, especially again, these are high value vehicles, and they did deliver some of them quite a few weeks ago. And they're expecting that to continue to explode in terms of the growth potential there. Some additional news that should be bullish for the company is they did have Bank of America. I'm seeing if the news article is available here. But they did have Bank of America announce today that they would be partnering to offer their financing services for the company. So Bank of America, one of the large big four banks in the United States, has a vehicle lending product, and they have essentially offered this to be able to provide financing for the Lucid vehicles. So that's obviously good, because when you enable financing, it opens up the space to be able to have additional investors who will come and put their money there, as well as have additional buyers who don't necessarily have $77,000 to shell out. Bank of America is one of the largest in the business, especially on the consumer side. And so having one of those larger banks to partner with obviously bodes well for the company overall. So this is a group that has over 41 million active users, and they're now going to have direct access to Lucid financing. So this is super cool and something that I'll be watching going forward. Few additional items I would highlight. Again, this is as of 11:15, so I imagine this has changed fairly dramatically, but they have a relatively low short interest compared to some of the larger EV stocks. Think of Rivian, think of Tesla, and the percentage held by institutions is huge, coming in nearly at 70% Keep in mind that the Saudi Wealth Fund is one of the largest holders of the company, and they are doing incredibly well on their investment, and they're someone who has made some seriously smart and very good strategic transactions and investments over the past few years. So this is one that we're going to watch. Again, the historical volatility is very, very high. But what I'm looking for going forward is I think that this is a great stock to buy 100 shares and sell covered calls. I don't like to encourage selling covered calls on red days, especially negative 5% red days. And at one point today, it was more than 10%. But it's something that the premiums are very, very high. And if you can buy 100 shares for $4,500 and sell $500 premiums, which is pretty close to the at the money for next week, then there's a lot of value in that capability. So it's something to evaluate, something to check out. I'm a big covered call fan. If you'd like to learn more about covered calls, feel free to watch some of the other videos and content that I have available. But it's something that the premiums was just so good, but the valuations for these companies are very, very high. And if you're forced to sell at $60, $50 a share, then as you can see, what would have happened over the past 3 months is you still would have ended up quite nicely. So something to check out and consider. Let me know in the comment section down below if you have any questions over the idea of selling covered calls or over Lucid Group in general. This is one that's going to continue to be volatile, and as such, I'll continue to cover it. So let me know in the comments down below. And if you find this content helpful, please leave a like and subscribe. Thanks. Talk to you later.